Thanks to Brilliant for supporting this video. Because you watch SciShow, Brilliant is offering you a 30-day free trial and 20% off an annual premium subscription at brilliant.org/scishow. There is currently no simple way to diagnose cancer. Cancer is a lot of different things, and there's just no way to develop one single straightforward test where doctors like prick your finger and a machine goes, "Yep, that's cancer." Except one day there might be, thanks to a gene that doesn't do anything. See, cancer is prone to turning on this one weird genetic sequence that's widely considered junk. It doesn't do much of anything for our bodies, even though it does make cancer worse. But one team of researchers is on the trail of this genetic interloper, and by finding it, they think they can find cancer, as in general. Here's how. Meet the genetic snippet known as long interspersed nuclear element 1, or line 1 for short. It doesn't do much. Junk DNA is thought to be like stuff that takes up space but has no useful function. And far less of our DNA is junk than scientists used to believe. But line 1 takes up space and has no useful function. It's grade A certified spam. Line 1 is a retrotransposon, a 6,000-ish letter sequence of genetic material that replicates by making RNA copies of itself and wandering all over the genome, inserting itself inside strands of DNA. This sequence makes a couple of proteins called ORF1P and ORF2P, which have the extremely important jobs of copying the line 1 sequence and pasting it elsewhere. And that is all line 1 does. Control C, Control V. I do want to point out that a molecular biologist calling a protein ORF1P is like calling it Protein McProtein Face, as generic as it could possibly get. This cut-and-paste tomfoolery accounts for 17% of our genome, and yet it contributes absolutely diddly-squat in terms of gene function. Every once in a while, an optimistic paper comes out assigning some helpful function to line 1, but it's optimistic. Some researchers have gone as far as to characterize retrotransposons like line 1 as genomic parasites. Like, the body just needs a pretty enthusiastic watchdog to keep these things in line. Transposons happen in a lot of organisms. Scientists think that at some point there must have been like a really good reason for a genetic sequence whose only function was to cut and paste itself. But if there used to be a good reason, it is not super evident now. Under most circumstances, these traveling sequences do nothing but clog up your chromosomes. That's a big source of stress for cells and can even cause disease. For instance, if line 1 cuts into the middle of a gene, it can break that gene entirely. If a gene is a set of instructions and you put a totally different set of instructions in the middle of that set of instructions, it's gonna get pretty garbled. It's actually been shown that line 1 butting in on genes that make blood clotting proteins can break the blood clotting process and cause hemophilia. As a result, healthy cells don't usually give line 1 much opportunity to do its thing, and they silence it in a few different ways, including by attaching chemical compounds called methyl groups to line 1 elements. This is a common strategy that cells use to turn down genetic material they're not using. A brain cell doesn't need to make insulin, right? Leave that to the pancreas. And since nobody needs to make line 1, everybody shuts it up. Here's the fun thing, though. Line 1 is allowed to turn back on in about 50% of all human cancers. Researchers don't really know why, but cancer cells do like to throw away all those little methyl group flags that keep genes silenced. Maybe they just benefit from the chaos. Whatever the reason, line 1 in particular nearly always seems to lose its methyl groups, which gives it the ability to turn back on, and the absolutely nothing it does can lead to genetic chaos. Like in colon cancer, activated line 1 is sometimes shown to be stuck in the middle of a tumor-suppressing gene called APC, breaking it, just like with hemophilia. Other studies show that by inserting itself into DNA, line 1 causes a bunch of breaks in that twisty backbone. That compromises the genome's overall stability, and that damage might aid tumor growth. Research also suggests that line 1 expression is related to damage to the tumor-suppressing p53 protein that regulates cell division and suppresses tumor growth in the body. In other words, line 1 can cause an awful lot of mischief for some supposedly harmless genetic junk mail. Just by doing its cut-and-paste thing, it's tilting the odds in cancer's favor. Even if a cancer wasn't looking to turn on line 1, so to speak, a cancer that does do that just by chance might have a better time. And so it goes that line 1 expression seems to be associated with basically half of the cancers, including ones like ovarian and gastroesophageal cancer that are often hard to diagnose because they keep a low profile, symptom-wise, until they're too advanced to easily treat. Cancers of the esophagus, colon, lung, breast, prostate, prostate, ovaries, uterus, pancreas, head, and neck all seem to fire up in concert with the line 1 garbage machine. But here's the amazing thing. It just so happens that if line 1 is making ORF1P, one of the proteins that carry it around, it's pretty easy to detect it in the blood. In a 2023 paper, researchers presented a super sensitive machine that can look for ORF1P in our blood plasma. In fact, the method works on as little as a half a drop of blood. The researchers found that the test was extremely accurate in detecting a wide range of cancers. They claim the test itself has a turnaround of just a couple of hours and costs less than $3 to produce. Imagine a procedure no more complicated than the finger sticks used to monitor blood sugar and diabetes. That's what we might be looking at in the future. Of course, this test cannot tell your doctor where in the body the cancer is hiding. Only that ORF1P is present, so you probably got cancer somewhere and more tests are needed. That means it's a simple, first-line screen that's easy to get to patients, not something to replace something more sophisticated like a PET scan. However, this test could also be used to monitor whether treatments are working. If a certain treatment is effective, doctors should be able to see blood levels of ORF1P dropping. Line 1 might be a couch-surfing, freeloading, cancer-helping genetic parasite, but its one redeeming quality seems to be that it's not crafty enough to hide its antics. In fact, it may end up snitching on the very cancers it is aiding. Finally, it's doing something worthwhile. This new tool is a great example of what's at the core of a lot of scientific thinking. Take something useless, or even something that has a purpose, and put it to work solving a totally different problem. To learn more about scientific thinking, you can take the Brilliant course all about it. Brilliant is an interactive online learning platform with thousands of lessons in science, computer science, and math. And they're supporting this SciShow video. Thanks, Brilliant! In their scientific thinking course, you can explore the laws of physics and principles of engineering with no previous knowledge required. You'll never look at a pulley or a kaleidoscope the same. To get started with your first 30 days free, you can go to brilliant.org/scishow or click the link in the description down below. That link also gives you 20% off an annual premium Brilliant subscription. Thanks to Brilliant for supporting us, thanks to you for watching us, and thanks to all the people who worked on this episode. It was fascinating.